Speak student.
Conditional statements, a la Shmoop. Some statements we make are more than just statements of fact or fiction. Like, Grandma, you look incredible after your makeover. Who's to say what category that particular statement belongs to? Some statements are conditional. Conditional statements are if-then statements that have two parts, a hypothesis and a conclusion. The hypothesis comes after the if and tells us the condition that must be satisfied. The conclusion comes after the then and tells us what happens if the hypothesis is true. They usually take the form, if hypothesis, then conclusion. If I do well on all my tests, then I will get all A's this semester. If it walks like a duck and quacks like a duck, then it probably is a duck. If you liked it, then you should have put a ring on it. Keep in mind that a conditional statement is only applicable if the hypothesis is true. If you liked it, then you should have put a ring on it. Duh. But we can't tell you what you should or shouldn't have done if you didn't like it. That's for Beyoncé to decide. Of course, mathematicians prefer numbers and symbols to long and complicated sentences. So they came up with a way of representing conditional statements in a different way. The statement if hypothesis P, then conclusion Q, can be represented by drawing an arrow from P to Q, like this. But not all conditional statements take the if-then form. Some of them might look like all hypothesis conclusion, or conclusion whenever hypothesis. Sneaky little devils. How can we write all dogs go to heaven in PQ form? Well, first let's write it as an if-then statement. All dogs go to heaven means that if we're talking about a dog, then it will go to heaven. We want to put that statement in PQ form, which looks like this. So really all we need to do is replace our P with our hypothesis and Q with our conclusion. Since our statement is, if it is a dog, then it will go to heaven, our hypothesis is, it is a dog, and our conclusion is, it will go to heaven. Draw an arrow in between them, and we've done it. We can even condense it further and maybe save a few trees. We have one last conditional statement for you before you go. If you learned something from this video, then you just got a little bit smarter. We did say a little bit.